Hello friends, welcome back to the third part of the topic column basis, where initially we had discussed regarding introductory part of the column basis, what actually is the column basis, its definition, its uses, its functions, and these all things we already had discussed. Then after in second part we just saw what are the types of column basis, that is slab based foundation, let me change the color, slab based foundation, gusseted based foundation and pocket based foundation. So in this lecture we are going to talk about the gusseted base foundation in detail, as we saw what is slab base foundation in the second lecture. This was the introductory part of slab base foundation. This was its diagram and this was the design criteria for the same. While in this lecture we'll be talking about what is gusseted base foundation. When load on the column is very heavy or when the column is subjected to axial load or moment, gusseted base foundation is provided. See, as we saw this slab base foundation, the load is always coming in axial direction to the column and it is transferred to the soil axially. But sometimes it may so happen that there is some moment created, is the load is not symmetric, and even if it is symmetric then it might be very heavy loading which may deflect the columns, and this base plate is not able to support the loading, there may be deflection in the column, so our slab based foundation might not be enough to handle this. So in this case we are using gusseted base foundation. It consists of a base plate, a gusseted plate, connecting angles and a web cleat angle. So before looking at the diagram for gusseted base foundation, I'll just explain you its working from the slab base foundation figure. Here when axial load is very heavy, suppose it is axial load or it may not be the axial loading, then how this slab base foundation may react is that it may turn over like this, or it may even turn like this, or it may get deflected. So in we are using a gusset plate over here. We are using a gusset plate like this. We are connecting this gusset plate like this so that it gets support till here, this up to this level. So this is how the gusseted base foundation work. Now let us see the components: base plate, gusset plate, connecting angles and web cleat angles. These all the things are shown in the figure here. This figure. So this is the column on which loading is there and this is the gusset plate. This is the side view. This is the base plate, like slab base foundation also we used to attach. This is the view B. As from this plan, this is view B, where we are able to see the entire gusset plate. But in view A, this, we will not be able to see the gusset plate entirely, but just thickness. That is what is shown over here. Here, see, gusset plate thickness is shown here. This. And the main thing how the gusset plate is connected is by using a gusset angle, 150 cross 75 cross 10 mm thickness. Again, moving towards the theoretical part. In case of gusseted base foundation, due to gusset plates, bearing area of the base plate increases. Here, looking at the figure. When we are using this gusset plate over here, and again here, the bearing area of the base plate, see, this is our base plate, right? So the area connected to the column is increasing here. So here again, the second role of the gusset plate is to increase the connection area between the base plate and the column. Hence the thickness of the base plate will be less than the thickness of the slab base for the same axial load, which means that the concrete block which we are providing below this gusset plate, the concrete block which is provided below this gusset plate is having more thickness than that of the base plate. Then after, these are the components of gusseted base foundation, that is column, Indian standard high beam 250, which is 54 kg per meter. Then cover plate 300 cross 12 mm thickness. Cover plate is shown over here. This is the cover plate. But the cover plate is understood here very easily, that is 300 cross 12 mm thickness. This is the cover plate, which is connected between the column and the gusset plate. That is a packing plate. We can even say that cover plate is the packing plate between gusset plate and the I section column. Then we have gusset plate of 10 mm thickness. Was at angles 150 cross 75 cross 10 mm thickness. That is the connection between this gusset plate and the base plate. Here it is shown. Gusset angle is connecting this both gusset plate and this base plate. Then we have base plate of thickness, dimension 600 cross 500 and thickness 12 mm. And 20 mm diameter bolts are used in 16 numbers on each face. Here it is shown, 20 mm diameter bolts, 16 numbers. These all are the 20 mm diameter bolts which are connecting the column to the gusset plate. So friends, this is all about the gusseted base foundation, which is a type of column basis. Thank you for watching.